हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस लेसन 8 ऑफ विस्टास मेमोरीज ऑफ चाइल्डहुड पार्ट 1, दैट इज़ द कटिंग ऑफ माय लॉन्ग हेयर. इट इज़ एन ऑटोबायोग्राफिकल एपिसोड बाय ज़ित्किला सा, अ नेटिव अमेरिकन वुमन हु स्ट्रगल्ड एंड ट्रायम्फ्ड इन अ टाइम व्हेन सीवियर प्रेजुडाइस प्रिवेल्ड. द राइटर डिस्क्राइब्स दैट हर फर्स्ट डे इन द लैंड ऑफ एप्पल्स वॉज एक्सट्रीमली कोल्ड. The ground was fully covered with snow, whereas the trees were not covered with snow. A bell rang, indicating breakfast bell. It was a loud sound that broke through the part of bell tower and reached into their sensitive ears. The disturbing sound of the tiptoe of shoes was making the writer restless. There was a continuous noise everywhere, as if the sounds were clashing with each other. There were people who were talking in an unknown language. She got so disturbed that she felt as if her freedom was lost. A woman with yellow face, white hair, went up to see the girls. Zitkala was placed in the line of the girls who were heading towards the dining room. She describes that they were the Indian girls who were wearing hard shoes and tight dresses. The small girls were wearing sleeved aprons and their hair were cut short. Zitkala was walking without making any noise of her shoes. She felt so ashamed when her blanket was removed from her shoulders. All the other Indian girls seemed to be very indecent to her, as everybody was wearing tight clothes, which were not a good thing as per the writer. As they were going to the dining room, the boys came from the opposite door. The writer notices the three boys who were, according to her, were brave. She says so because they were also the new entrants into the school and were not wearing the dress like others. She looked at them while they were standing behind her. They were also not comfortable like her. A small bell rang. All the students dragged their chairs. The writer to pulled it and get seated at once. But she found herself noticed by all the other girls who haven't seated yet. The next bell rang. All the others seated themselves. The writer too, once again, just to mend her mistake, seated. Suddenly, she heard a manly voice from one corner of the room. She tries to see the man but found everyone looking down towards their plates. While she was looking at them, she was that the yellow-faced woman was constantly looking at her. She dropped her eyes but was feeling uncomfortable about being watched like that. The man stopped speaking, and with the ringing of the bell of the third time, all of them picked up their forks and knives. The writer got so afraid by the time that she started crying, as she didn't want to get into such risky task anymore. The writer says that the way of eating was not the only thing which she thought to be the hardest one, but there was one more terrible thing that her friend Judwin told her, as she could understand a few words of English. So she had heard the pale-faced woman saying that their hair should be cut down. The writer didn't want to do it because she had heard her mother saying that only untrained warriors that were arrested by the enemy cut their hair. In their community, only those who either were at funeral or were cowards cut short their hair. As Zitkala was neither a weakling nor a mourner, so she didn't want to cut her hair. Both Judwin and Zitkala discussed about their destiny, as they knew that their hair will be cut short. Judwin was of a view that they should agree to what the authorities wanted to, as they were stronger than these two girls. But the writer was not ready for it, so she decided to go against the school authorities. She went upstairs very quietly without being noticed in order to safeguard her hair. She was trying to walk very quietly because her moccasins were chinched with shoes that make sound while walking. She crossed the hall went into a room without knowing where she was going. She entered a room which had three beds and green curtains, and it was a little bit dark. She crawled in under a bed, hides herself. The writer was trembling whenever she heard somebody coming. She could hear many voices. Everybody was calling out her name, including her friend Jutwin. She didn't reply. Soon she heard the sound of steps and voices growing stronger and stronger. Women and girls entered the room where she was hiding. They were searching for her everywhere. Even the curtains were removed. Soon she was found under the bed and pulled out. She tried to safeguard herself, even scrapped the other person, but she was taken away and tied up to a chair. The writer cried a lot, as she doesn't want any more to cut her hair. Suddenly, she felt a pair of scissors behind her neck. Soon her hair were cut down. She lost all her confidence, felt that she had always been humiliated since she was taken away from her mother. She recalled all her bad moments that embarrassed her. As people had gazed on her, she was thrown into the air like a puppet, but this time her hair was cut down. She felt like a coward. She was crying. She wailed for her mother, as she used to console her in her sad moments. But today, no one came to console her. No one tried to know her point of view. She felt like an animal, and she was being guided by some herder, and there was no one to control or console her. Thank you.